any soul, I'm going to be doing that for somebody.
Amen.
I'm not going to remain here. I'm going to be sponsoring a whole city. I'm going to be a blessing to my people. Phone calls will no longer intimidate me. You know, when you don't have enough, when people call you, grand, say, I hope it's not money. I hope they are not about to ask for money. Because you are not sufficient. You don't have enough. And you, maybe you want to be a blessing. But now, your situation is that you need help. And you don't want anybody to see you as stingy. So you don't want them to call you. You don't want them to make a request. Tell yourself, it is just for a moment. It's just for a moment. Glory to Jesus. So get a dream. Number two is believe your dream. Believe your dream. Because it is one thing to have a dream, to get a dream. It's another thing to believe it. When you believe in your dream, it will reflect in the way you carry it. You know, when you have a dream, and you have the mindset of it might not work, you don't share it. Because you don't want somebody to come and say, I thought you said by this time next year, this business will have had 3 branches. So why are you still on the same spot? You don't share it. You say, if I will fail, let me fail alone. But you see, you need to believe in your dream. Amen. I'm not saying share all the secrets of your life. But when it is a dream from the Lord, the more the devil threatens your mind that it won't come to pass, the more you should share it. The more, you know, at times we think Joseph was a fool to have told his parents, to have told his brethren. Why would you do that? You are just cutting a thread for yourself. But he needed to convince himself these things are real.
Come on.
They will come to pass. So he shared his dream. He shared it. He said, you see me as the youngest. Very soon I'm going to be the biggest.
Amen.
I'm going to be the biggest. Yes. Now it doesn't matter where you are now. God is able to lift you from here. He's well able. As you are driving through the street of America, Atlanta, I told my father and the Lord, I said, I will not stop confessing that Nigeria will change. Amen. Something came to my mind. I said, it's not too big for God to lift a nation and change a nation, change our culture, change our ways of thinking, they change our economy. It is not a big deal for God. God can do it.
Yes.
The nations of the world like Singapore, they used to be very poor. God has changed them over a few period of time. Now, if he has done it, he can do it again.
Yes.
And if he can do it for nations, he can do it for you.
Yes.
Because the Bible calls you a holy nation,
yes,
a peculiar people. God has chosen you. He has called you, you know, out of darkness into his marvelous light. And when light breaks, you know, when day breaks, light just vanishes.
Oh, yes.
Switch on light, darkness disappears. So when God wants to change your story, it doesn't take him much time. He will do it for you. Oh, God, 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 my God will do it for you. If there be anything you have seen around that glorifies God, but yet is not in your life, tonight my God hands it to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Because you must give him glory. Your life must give him glory. Your life must become a testimony. It shall come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. Every advantage around your life that the devil has covered, I command that cover to tear up. I command that cover to tear up. I command your advantage to show up in the name of Jesus Christ. Your advantage will come alive in the name of Jesus Christ. Number three,
hallelujah.
If you are going to be a winner by wisdom,
yes, Lord,
you must ignore resistances.
Amen.
So many of us, we keep fighting resistances. They talk, you talk back. They talk. What the devil wants to do is to distract you. The devil wants to distract you. He will, when you begin to jaw with them, they speak, you speak, they speak, you speak, they do this, you are reacting to their activities.
Yeah.
That's one way never to go forward.
Yeah.
Never. seen a leader, somebody ahead, that is not backstabbed?
Never, no.
Yes, no.
No.
People we talk against you.
That's long.
People we, even people you think are your fans. On some occasions they will say, even though I'm following him, I don't believe it. And the person they told will come and tell you. And you, if you are not careful, you will feel like dying. Say, what? You mean? Say, please don't confront him. He told me in confidence. He told me in confidence, don't confront him. And you are like, what am I going to do with this? This person is still dancing around you. He comes around, when you see him, you become terrible. You feel terrible. That's not the pathway of winners. Oh my God. Everyone here needs a mentor. My father in the Lord is a great man.
Yes, Lord.
Hey. You see people, is we around him that will be angry for him. And he will not be saying, no, it's not like that. And he will be giving excuses. I've seen him give excuse and excuse for people. It got to a point, I've discovered that it's like this man has no capacity to hate. I'm telling you, I can count on occasions. Somebody will tell me something terrible about him. And I see my father close to this person. I will say, you have to be careful with this person. Look at what. He said, no, he didn't mean it that way. I said, what is the meaning of this? Sincerely, I can count. From our landlord one time, the landlord of the church that gave us a particular property. You know, when this person says things, he will say it with annoyance. Tell Philippo. I will feel terrible when I mention it to him. He said, no, that's not the intention. My God. Today, those people, we were looking up to those people that time. Now they are looking up to him now. Amen. Ignore resistances. Ignore. Genesis chapter 37 verse 4. The Bible says, and when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably unto him. But was there any way in the Bible where the Bible says, and Joseph could not speak peaceably unto them?
No. Okay.
When your brothers hate you, you will know. They are your elder brothers. If it's a younger brother that hates an elder brother, there can be some politics. But when your elder brother hates you, you will know.
I'm sure.
Because there are things he ought to do for you as a brother. He will not. So it will not be hidden.
That's true.
But Joseph
never replied.
Not once. The father will say, take food and go and give to them. Get to daughter. Discover they are not there. Search for them. Say they have left this place. So where are they? If, you know the way. Do you do me? I do you. You know the way. It's your father has sent to them to give them provision. You got to where your father sent you, and they are not there. You just turn back. Say, Papa, I got there. Like their manner is, they have moved. They are no longer there. So this is the food, so that they can starve. But Joseph was not like that. Never. If there are resistances around your life, bear it. It will be for a season.
Amen.
Bear it. In the office, some people have lost jobs they shouldn't have lost. Because there were resistances in the office. What is the meaning of this? I'm tired and fed up. And they walk out on the job. And that's their destiny they are walking away from. Don't let people push you out of where God has ordained for you.
Hallelujah.
Don't let it. Winners don't do that. Winners don't do that. Job said, all the days of my appointed life, shall I wait until my change comes? I will wait. Waiting is not easy, but he said, I will wait until my change comes. I wait. Doesn't matter how long it takes me, I will wait. I'll wait. You're in a marriage. It seems as if it's not working. Wait. God is faithful.
Amen.
It will work. God is on your side. He's not against you.
Amen.
It will work.
Amen.
It will work.
Yes, Lord.
First, believe in it. It will work. What the devil wants is busy doing. happening around your life is for you to say it will not work. To confirm what is planning. I don't know how many of you have dreamt, you have had bad dreams. You dreamt, you just woke up and you discovered that you died and they were conducting your funeral. And you see, I died, I really died. I found myself at my own funeral in a dream. And when I woke up, I knew from years of training that when you have such dreams, the devil is looking for your approval
to kill you.
When you have a negative dream, what the devil is looking for is for your approval.
For you to agree
that it happened. Immediately I got up, I started saying, Father, thank you, because with long life you shall satisfy.
Hallelujah.
And you will show me your salvation. And it's, I can't remember how many years now. I'm still kicking. Hallelujah. God is faithful. God is faithful. I used to get worried. Some time ago, when I eat in my dream, I will get worried because back home, they believe that when the devil wants to kill you, he will bring food for you in your dream. Until I came across a wisdom. And wisdom spoke to me that each time you eat in your dream, wake up and give thanks to God. I said, Lord, you gave me food. In real life and in the dream, you still gave me some loss. See, the devil will not bring you food again. He will not bring. I can't remember the last time I ate in my dream. Now the devil said, "This crazy man. If I bring him food, he will wake up and give thanks to God." But some people will begin to seek for deliverance. I ate in my dream. Come on, eat again. I'm going to find Jesus. What I'm saying to you, hallelujah. What I'm saying to you, some people in deliverance balance, we frown at it.
Yes.
They say, you are not eating poison. One of our deacons ate poison many years ago. He ate the chicken in his dream, woke up and vomited chicken. So I'm not saying that I do not know there are satanic food.
Yeah.
But I'm saying faith overcomes. Faith overcomes. When you encounter such, turn it around against the devil.
Yeah.
And you'll see victory come.
Amen.
Victory comes your way.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Yeah.
Number four, expand your dream. When dream comes, most of the time, they don't come very big. They come small. Like a little thought. We can actually start another church. Let's just start a small one in one corner. Then, someone said, why do a small church when we can do a big church? So, don't let your dream remain the way it started. No matter the opposition. When they oppose the dream of Joseph, the Bible said, recorded that he dreamt another dream. And that dream was larger than the first.
Yes.
The first time he dreamt that his brothers, the sheaves of his brothers, were bowing down to his own sheep. But when he dreamt another one, he said he saw 11 stars. And said he saw the sun and the moon. And they were bowing down. He added his father and his mother. The dream became bigger. The initial one was difficult to accomplish. He added something else. That's the way of God. When men are saying there is a casting down, the Bible says you shall say there is a lifting. You have just mounted on a small rostrum. They say you shouldn't be there. God said, climb higher.
Amen.
That's the way God operates. That's the operation of the Spirit of God. He wants things to get better for you. The path of the just is like a shining light. It shines more and more unto the perfect day. As we behold him as in a mirror, the glory of God, we are changed from glory to glory as by the Spirit of the Lord. God wants us to keep moving on.
Yes.
He doesn't. God knows there will be oppositions. The children of Israel got to the bank of the Red Sea, and they saw the Red Sea. They looked back, and they saw the Egyptians pursuing them. And they stopped. Natural thing to do is to stop. And God just called on Moses and said, why are the people stopping? I said, God, can't you see the Red Sea? He said, tell them to move forward. Natural man will say, to where? But a man that recognizes the voice of God and the force of the Spirit knows that when God asks you to move forward, he's not setting a trap for you, he's going to make a way for you.
Yes.
When he asks you to move forward, it is not a trap. It is a preparation for a way.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
And at the end of the day, God made a way.
Amen.
That is the pattern of God, my brother. My sister, that is the pattern of God. So you need to expand your dream. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 37, in that verse 4, he dreamt a dream. In verse 9, the Bible says, and he dreamed yet another dream, and told it his brethren, and said, behold, I have a dream more. And behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars made obeisance to me. Don't stop on dreaming small, dream bigger. That's wisdom. In this, let me tell you, at times, when we ask God for some things, we allow the natural to take over and we make the demand small. At times I ask myself, the small one who will do it is God. The big one who will do it is God. Why not ask what you want? Why pity God and say, God, so that, you know, I don't want you to bother yourself too much. Do this small for one for me and I will glorify you. And that's not what you really want. If it does the small one, you now come back, I'm actually sorry. That was not what I meant. I thought it was going to be difficult for you. That's why I asked for the small one. Now I want this bigger one. It's better to just believe God. You see, one thing about prayer is that prayer is a place where you don't pay to make requests to God. You don't have to pay because it's big or small. Just make your request and leave it in the courtyard of God. God knows how to handle it at the appropriate time. What I'm saying to you, in this year of radical faith, stretch your faith a little bigger. Make it a little bigger. Tell God, if there is a project your natural self tells you is going to take 5 years to accomplish, tell yourself, by the end of this year, I see you doing it for me.
Yeah.
And God is able. God is able. God is able. When Daddy moved to the headquarters church, I was one of the people who told him, I said, is that the way we should do this? Daddy left the VI church, like the mother church, where all the World Assembly churches were batting from, you know. When he moved to Lekki, I said, I thought we were going to buy some buses and move people. And I said, no. That when you see a general, they don't stay on conquered grounds. Generals move to new grounds to conquer. So he moved with a few people and they started building. And the hand of the flesh or the mind of the flesh will say, how many years will it take them to build this structure? At least Pastor Festus has been there. Our choir director here has been there. Even when, I think when he came, he wouldn't be able to visualize what is on ground now. How God did it is still a wonder. With the few people that were on ground, because Daddy moved away from all the big men that we had on VR and came to Lekki, and God took over. It is good to trust God.
Amen.
It is wisdom to trust God.
Amen.
That's why I know that no matter what is in your heart, no matter how big it is, the Lord is going to put it in your hands.
Amen.
Somebody didn't believe me.
Amen.
The Lord is going to make it happen for you.
Amen.
If I can talk you out of unbelief and talk you into faith tonight, my job will have been done. I prophesy that no matter the challenge around your life, the mighty hand of the living God will put a stop to that challenge in the name of Jesus Christ. God will put a stop to it. As you see it with the eyes of faith, you will receive it with your hands of faith. In the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. Whatever the devil is saying concerning your progress, this year, the devil will fail. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Number five. Perfect a life of diligence. If you are going to be a winner, perfect a life of diligence. Because no dream fulfills itself without deliberate discipline of diligence. There is no dream that fulfills itself without a deliberate discipline of diligence. Oh God, seest thou a man diligent in his work, he shall stand before kings and not before men. Diligence, pace. Many people wait until they have their home before they serve. If you do that, you lose out on the reward of diligence. There is a man watching you, he who is able to greatly bless you. Somebody watching you. Somebody. Don't wait until you see, catch some people's eyes on you before you begin to act. Some people are actors. When they see people watching them, they act. When nobody is watching them, they slow down. If you do that, then you are not going to become what God has ordained for you to be. You've got to make your life a life of diligence. When nobody's watching, please walk. Genesis chapter 37 verse 2. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, was feeding the flock of his brethren, with his brethren. And the lad was with the sons of Bilhah and with the sons of Zilpah, his father's wife. And Joseph brought unto his father their evil report. He did not join their evil ways. He brought their evil report. He was feeding the flock as a teenager. When other teenagers were playing, you know, their time away, he was feeding the flock. And God said, I can depend on this one. Can depend on this one. If you don't learn diligence when you are small, there is no future of greatness. Because the higher you go, the tougher it becomes. The higher you go, if you don't learn to combine your business with your life, you know, vocation. I mean, your ministry with your life vocation. God may not be interested in enlarging your life vocation. Because the larger it becomes, the greater the vacuum or the void between you and God becomes. But if at every point God promotes you, heaven benefits.